Howdy folks, thanks for stopping by. Today we'll be learning how to turn junk into more junk. Well, in particular, emergency space heaters. But first, we're going to be doing a quick comparison of oils for fuel source, of course. So get what you need. Here we go. I like these little hot sauce bottles. They're very durable. They hold enough fluid for approximately 9 hours of continued use. The hole here is just the right size for the wick. And how do I fill these bottles up? Well, I put the oil in just a regular old oil can, stick it in there and fill it up. I only fill it up to the bottom of the neck here, so don't want to overfill it. But now look at that, there's a wick. Did you notice there's a wick inside of there? Now how do I get that wick out of there? Well, I'll show you. I had to make a special little tool to do it. And this is the end of it right there. Okay, yeah, see that little nubbin sticking out there? It catches the wick, so I stick this thing in the bottle here and catch the wick, and it pulls it out. So that's how that goes. These are the wicks that I use. It says 1/8 inch, and it comes in a little package like that for about $1.99. Of course, the wicks do wear out over a period of time. You have to buy new wicks. I'm starting with this canned heat, which is the cost wise is you buy two of these in a two pack for around $9. We have olive oil here, which I spent $5 on this bottle at the dollar store, and you can variety of prices there, $5 to $10 for olive oil, let's say. So basically, so far it seems a little cheaper. Now we've got vegetable oil, big old bottle of that for that's a few dollars, right? At the same token, we've got the ultra pure lamp oil, and the ultra pure lamp oil, this cost around $9 plus change also. So we have $9 for a bottle of that. We've got a few dollars for a big bottle of that. We've got $5 to $10 for a bottle of that. And we've got Sterno, which I'm just throwing this in for a sideline here in the video. People have mentioned things about Sterno, so I'm trying to show everybody how these products all perform. Okay, so move that out of the way. And oh, there's Santa Claus. I got him for Christmas. So now we're gonna light up these little burners and see how they work. This is the dark green for the olive oil. This is more of a yellowish. That's the Wesson oil. And this is the ultra pure lamp oil. Let's just take a look and see how they do for a minute. You can see on the right, the ultra pure lamp oil has got a little bit bigger flame going. It looks like the olive oil, the flame in the olive oil is getting smaller and smaller. I think it's having a harder time being sucked up through the wick. And I think about the same thing is happening. Let's see, yeah, it's about the same thing's happening with the Wesson oil. It doesn't want to travel up that wick very well. So, as we can already see that, they say that these two can be used, but depending on the application, It doesn't look like these are going to work at all for the applications of this bottle. This Sterno, personally, I don't think this is the way to go. $9 for two cans. Each can lasts for about 2.5 hours. So you got 5 hours worth of heating or cooking for $9. But if I did go that way, I'd find something like this perhaps, drill it out, make the holes a lot bigger, because with sterno, you definitely want a good combustion, good airflow. Definitely helps reduce all those bad particles. But I'd find something like this perhaps, and drill the top out also some more. And it's kind of looks cute, and it would provide some heat, but personally, this is not the way I'd be going. These bottles last about 8, 9 hours, depending, but approximately like that. Once they're halfway down, they're gonna start to lose the energy, the flame heights a little bit, getting down, because it's harder to drop that wick. Oh, as you can see, I tricked it out a little bit so I can cook something. The washers are a little bit higher than this, so there is airflow in between here. It's not solid on there. It is above the hole, and I'd only use two burners though while I was cooking anything. I've got a spring here. I've got a little nut there. And as you can see, I want some airflow through this because I want to have airflow, as much airflow around this object as possible. And we'll get the nut on here real quick. I'll show you what I'm doing here. But yeah. Let's see, give this a. As you can see, you notice these are bent inward a little bit. That's to accommodate for the screw head on the inside of here. Lots of ventilation holes. Got this thing. So what happens here? I've got a spring here. As you can see, it comes out all the way to there. And I'll just be putting some more springs on it and show you the rest of that. Also, this is a shield. It's to keep the heat off of the bottles. As you can see, we've got our shield in place. And those four burners are enclosed. Safety-wise, we've got a real nice non-tip base to it. Well, folks, I had a fun time making this video. I really hope you enjoyed it. We don't know where or when the next emergency will strike. Alternate heat sources could save the day.